of God being revealed in the person of Jesus Christ. That the Lord demonstrates to his apostles and he demonstrates to all of us that he is Lord over all the creation. Lord of all creation. And so when God speaks, there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It's done. Over. Quiet. Be still. And there's an obedience in creation. You know, it's kind of like, I like to point to the trees out there. And you know, God's creation, since God is a mystery, that God's creation, all of it, including you and I, are part of his mystery. Each of us, each part of God's creation reveals a part of God's mystery. It's not the kind of mystery that you, when you go down to Borders, you look in a book and you're going to get a few clues and you're going to solve the puzzle, the riddle. It's not that kind of mystery. The kind of mystery that God is a mystery that you and I have to enter into. It's the kind of mystery that we have to embrace. We're not going to figure it out. And if we're patient, and we're humble, and we're obedient, then what we're going to see is that the revelation and mystery of God will continue to unfold right before our very eyes. And so every part of God's creation glorifies him. Just like the trees out there. Right now they're in full bloom. By the very nature of what they are, as trees, they glorify God. They are being what God created them to be. As summer passes, autumn comes upon us, the leaves of the trees will begin to change colors, and then quickly they will fall to the ground. When was the last time you saw a deciduous tree that said, "I'm not shedding my leaves this year"? Kind of stupid. We laugh at that, but the reality is that God's creation, except for one little part of God's creation, glorifies him by the very nature of how he created. Can you think of what part of nature that is? It's the part of nature that's sitting in the church today, you and I. We have the power and we have the capacity to say, no. No, I'm not going to be obedient. No, I'm not going to serve. No, I'm not going to glorify you. No, I'm not going to do as you've asked me to do. I'm not going to be who you created me to be. And in a certain sense, it's the reason why I've said before that parents are so appreciative of their children when they say yes, because they know they can say no. They know they can say no. But in the beginning, it was not that way. In the beginning, in paradise, in the Garden of Eden, there was harmony in creation. All of God's creation lived in harmony. Until the part of God's creation that is you and I said, I'm not going to serve, I'm going to do as I want. And invited chaos and sin into the world. And so what you see in the gospel this morning is Jesus performing an exorcism over the elements and calming the chaos of the demonic elements that are creating all kinds of problems. And he says, that's enough. Be still. But there's a consequence for disobedience. Listen. shall it bring forth to you as you eat of the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall get bread to eat until you return to the ground from which you were taken. For you are dirt, and to dirt you shall return. From that moment on, pain, suffering, struggle entered the world. You and I have to live with the consequence of sin. You and I have to live with the consequence of disobedience. And yet, through all of that, God has entrusted His creation to you and I. He has made us stewards of His creation. What is a steward? A steward is someone who is given something to take care of that does not belong to him, but for which he must give a full accounting for in the end. So I want to talk a little bit about Pope Francis's encyclical that came out the other day. And there's a lot of rhetoric out there with regards to the encyclical. The Pope is choosing sides, he's choosing this side, this camp, over this camp. It's a political, he's making a political statement. But I want to say to you, the Pope is neither a scientist nor a politician. He's speaking as a pastor. He's speaking as a pastor. And he's reminding us of what is in Scripture. That we have a moral obligation with regard to God's creation, and that there is an effect, he says, when we don't pay attention. The focus of the encyclical is not global warming. The focus of the encyclical is the heart of the human person. The heart of the human person. And the Holy Father goes on to explain what happens when our hearts are not in union with God. He talks about the unbridled materialism. He talks about what happens when 20% of the world's population continues to consume 80% of the world's natural resources. And he says the poorest of the poor are on the receiving end of that. He talks about the effect, and he even made this statement on Twitter. He said that God's creation is beginning to look more and more like a pile of filth. That's what he said. He talked about what happens, the effect of years upon years upon years of human waste created by human consumption. When we throw things away in this throwaway culture, and things are not biodegradable. What happens? And although scientists have unlocked many of the mysteries of creation, they have not unlocked all of them. We don't know all the answers. I don't know if global warming is a problem or not. It's not really an issue. That's not the issue for me. What the issue for me is, God is going to ask me a question, just as He's the same question He's going to ask every single human person when I have to stand before Him. What did you do with what I gave you? Just as parents are going to answer for their children. They are stewards over their children. Parents will have to answer for the stewardship of their children. And you know that when parents parent well, the consequence of good parenting is blessing on the family. That's the consequence of good parenting. But when parents don't parent well, the consequence of poor parenting is what? Chaos. Broken relationships. Holy Father is saying that broken relationships have an effect on creation. You and I. Something as simple you're saying that if anybody dismisses this encyclical simply because they disagree about global warming, you're making a big mistake. You're making a big mistake, and it's less than humble. Francis is not saying anything different than Benedict said, or John Paul II said, or many popes before him. We have a responsibility to Christ to recognize that He is Lord of the world and not you and I. In the end, it's going to come down to